If you can, introduce your pup to different sounds, different experiences. See dogs, big and small. Let him get confident if he's not already. I like my dogs to be confident from the get-go. But sometimes you also have to give your dog a little bit more time. Also in the development, sometimes there are periods that they are like puberty in the humans. That some uncertainty could be there. I haven't experienced it yet in my own dogs, but I know some others that do have, and also those dogs turned out fine. So don't exclude a dog if it has some uncertainty just in an in-between age and is not an adult yet. That's also the case why they normally don't put the dogs against formidable quarry if they are too young, and start up with smaller ones, for example rats, and then work their way up instead of going for the biggest and the baddest from the get-go, to build up confidence and also get the dog to a learning curve. You see how he looks at me? So nice that he really likes doing things together, enjoying walks and building your own relationship. The dog wants to be one of the pack. It's not that a Bull and Terrier breed is a pack breed, but they bond in that magnificent way to their handler, their owner. That is even more than a normal pack relationship, in my understanding. And that's really beautiful and an awesome experience to get. So if you have a Bull and Terrier, don't make a fool of you. Say that they are not pack animals, because indeed they are not. They're single-handedly doing what they need to do. But on the other hand, they do form a formidable relationship with a human.